Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to explain about isolation and purification of plasmid DNA.
Isolation of plasmid, it is generally involved three steps. One is the growth of bacterial culture, harvesting and lysis of the bacterial cell using either detergent, alkali, organic solvent, heat. The choice among these methods depend on plasmid size, bacterial strain, and the last one is the purification of plasmid DNA. Bacterial culture growth curve. Depending on the nutritional status, bacteria exhibit different growth pattern, which include lag phase, log phase, stationary phase and the death phase. So usually the lag phase bacteria, when it is in the log phase, there the culture will be utilized for plasmid isolation. Role of different chemicals used during isolation and purification of plasmid DNA. EDTA, it removes the exopolysaccharide from gram-negative cell and facilitates cell lysis. Lysozyme, alkali, it attacks peptidoglycan and weaken out membranes of cells. 0.2 normal sodium hydroxide cause gentle lysis of the cell. RNAs, it removes RNA. Phenol, chloroform and isoamyl alcohol in the ratio of 24 is to 1. This remove proteins, DNA, RNA that are not soluble in this solvent. Phenol denatures and extract protein. Sodium dodecyl sulfate, detergent action, it bring the plasmid out of the cell. 2 molar ammonium acetate or 2.5 molar sodium acetate isopropanol. This cause precipitation of DNA species that are present in sample. Magnesium chloride, improve the recovery of DNA. Ethanol, precipitation of DNA. Plasmid isolation method, either alkali SDS lysis or rapid boiling procedure. Alkali SDS lysis, it could be either if you take a growing cell or it could be a culture which we can take. If we take a growing cell, we have to treat with TRIS-EDT and then we have to treat with lysis mixture in the buffer, which consists of lysozyme, RNA, bromophenol, bloom. Put in a slot of agarose gel, add SDS, that is sodium dodecyl sulfate, seal the slot of agarose gel, do the electrophoresis, stain and detect with ethidium bromide. Now in case of a culture cells, if we take the culture cells, then centrifuge it, discard the supernatant, collect the pellet, treat with TRIS-EDTA. Treat with sodium hydroxide, SDS, that is sodium dodecyl sulfate, add potassium acetate plus glacial acetic acid plus water, centrifuge at 10,000 G for 5 minutes, supernatant is collected, treat with phenol and chloroform, isoamyl alcohol, then electrophoresis will be done. In case of rapid boiling procedure, the culture was taken and centrifuged at 4000 RPM, discard the supernatant. Now the pellet will be taken and added lysis buffer, add lysozyme, inactivate lysozyme by boiling for 90 seconds, centrifuge for 10 minutes, discard pellet which consists of cell envelope and chromosomal DNA. Later, the supernatant was taken, add sodium acetate plus isopropanol, then DNA will be precipitated out, centrifuge at 14,000 RPM, discard the supernatant, then precipitate will be taken and dried in vacuum desiccator, and add TRIS buffer to the plasmid sample so that we can preserve this plasmid. Plasmid purification of plasmid DNA can be done by four methods. One is isopycnic ultracentrifugation. Second is the chromatography. Third is the solvent extraction, or it could be done by preparative electrophoresis. So these are the four methods which is used for the isolation of plasmid. In case of isopycnic centrifugation, caesium chloride containing ethidium bromide is used for isopycnic ultracentrifugation, in which if there is a chromosomal fragment, it will bind more to the ethidium bromide, less biont density, lower band in the centrifuge tube. See, this is the it will form a lower band in the centrifuge tube. Whereas in case of plasmid form, if it is a plasmid DNA, then it will bind less to the ethidium bromide, more biont density, upper band in the ultracentrifuge tube, recovered and collected. From this, the plasmid will be collected, the upper band will be collected. Later on, if the second type, that is chromatographic type, then here hydroxyapatite column hydroxyapatite column will be loaded with the sample lysate. Adjust the column condition with using PO4 concentration, then protein RNA elute first, plasmid and chromosomal fragment if present will bind to the column. Now this plasmid will be eluted, rising the PO4 concentration, then finally whatever the plasmid is left out, it will become, then if chromosomal DNA, if it is present, still bind to the column. So in this column chromatography, we can elute the plasmid, whereas the chromosomal DNA contamination, if it is present, it will bind to the column. By increasing the PO4 concentration, we can elute the plasmid from the column. Solvent extraction. Here first we will add phenol, centrifuge the in solvent extraction, we take the plasmid, that is the clear lysate of the cell culture. See, first in all the experiment, first we shake the cell, gently lysis the cell, discard the debris, attached chromosomal DNA, clear lysate will be taken for this all these experiment. Then solvent, in case of solvent extraction, we will add phenol to the clear lysate, centrifuge at 14,000 G for 20 seconds, then lower organic layer will be taken, re-extracted with TE buffer, and it will be re-extracted with a TE buffer. After centrifugation at 4000 G for 20 seconds, the supernatant will be collected, and pull aqueous supernatant together, add phenol, chloroform, extract, collect aqueous layer, purified DNA solution will be got from this, and then add ammonium acetate and magnesium chloride ethanol, then centrifuge at 4 degrees centigrade for 14,000 G at 10 minutes, collect the precipitate, that's the pellet, discard the supernatant. Now dry in a vacuum desiccator, add dissolve in tris EDTA, then store at 4 degrees centigrade. The plasmid will be stored at 4 degrees centigrade. Preparative electrophoresis. Plasmid molecule, especially in their complete super helical covalently closed circle form, can be easily separated from RNA. Large fragment of chromosomal DNA by electrophoresis in agarose gel. Preparative electrophoresis can give mg quantities of plasmid DNA. Gel electrophoresis can also give the idea about molecular weight if reference molecular weight marker are incorporated in the run. Conformation of plasmid DNA. Now the plasmid DNA may appear in the following 5 conformation. One is supercoiled, which is also called as a covalently closed circular DNA, because it is fully intact in both the strand uncut. So it is called as a supercoiled. Next is relaxed region, relaxed circular DNA. It is DNA is fully intact but relaxed. Supercoiled is removed. Whereas in case of supercoiled denatured DNA, small quantity occur following excessive alkaline lysis. Both strands are uncut but are not correctly paired, resulting in compacted plasmid form. In case of nicked DNAs, nicked open circular DNA has one strand cut, whereas in case of linear DNA has both the strands cut at only one site. Now this is the relative electrophoretic mobility of these DNA, that is plasmid DNA conformation in the gel, where you can see that there is a linear plasmid or the linear DNA will have a band in this form, whereas supercoiled plasmid will have a, this is the band of supercoiled plasmid. Whenever there is a nick in the supercoiled plasmid, we can see this is the nicked circle, whereas the supercoiled one, after if there is a nick, that this one is the one. If it is a dimer, see these two are monomer, whereas this one is a dimer, which consists of supercoiled plasmid DNA with a nick and nicked circular DNA. So these are the dimer, which will show the band in this way.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.